What was it like playing your character in this movie?
Well, I lost my voice twice, so that was part of it. It was sweaty. It was really, really, really hot when we were filming. And so those scenes where I am profusely sweating is not makeup. That is full on my perspiration. You can pretty much smell it from the theater. It's bad.
Was it just the heat, or some of the film looks like it's kind of tiresome? Did you get to...
Oh, yeah. No, that's part of it, is I'm, like, jumping around, like, eating plastic steaks off the ground and weird stuff. It was interesting.
What kind of stuff were you able to do, seeing as I read that there was a lot of ad-libbing in this?
There was a ton of ad-libbing. It was a lot of fun, though, too. My favorite thing was to go in and out of character real quickly. So, in and out of the demonic character, I should say. It's like, so I'd be talking to Marlon, blah, 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 and then all of a sudden be like, I'm possessed. But better than that.
Yeah.
Because that was really bad.
So what was it like working with Marlon, seeing as he was the writer, producer, and an actor in it?
It's intimidating, because in a lot of ways, Marlon is like something I think so many people in this industry want to be. It's like having this like empire and being so multi-talented and just going to work and killing it and being a pro and having energy to spare, and he's like in crazy good shape. I'm like, how does that happen? You and Jaime are hilarious and hot. Not fair.
It's a lovely scarf you're wearing.
This is a sash, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm selling these. This is part of my new clothing line. Jesus pieces. Oh. And I got like the shoes that the Pope be wearing. Oh, I love her. Suede, green, brown.
And the Pope hats.
I can't keep them. You know that is love,
you
know.
Okay, you know what? That's enough. Thank you so much. That's right. Can we help my daughter, please?
She was a really white girl on me. Oh my God. I was like, whoa. All right.
Calm down, man.
Whoa. Dog, y'all some crazy ass. Man, y'all thought I was gonna shoot this bitch? I'm just gonna pistol whip her until she weakened.
What was it like working with Jaime then? Like...
Working with Jaime was amazing. She is so funny on and off screen. Yeah, I really love her.
How was the dynamic between you and Jaime, seeing as she has to play your mother?
Yeah, I mean, it was not mother-daughter at all. Like, we're... I feel she's pretty inappropriate. I'm pretty inappropriate, so we got along. Mm-hmm. But you know, she definitely is a pro. I was impressed every day working with her.
So seeing as you're both kind of inappropriate, did that ever, you know, come into conflict, or did that add to the story?
Oh no, it was not a conflict in this movie. Mm-mm. Inappropriate, bring it on. It's pretty much. Pretty much the rule.
How much of the script did you stick to, and how much of it did you ad-lib?
It's hard to say, because we did a couple takes every scene on script, and then a couple takes ad-libbing. So it's probably 50-50.
Who was the funniest person to work with off camera?
Oh, that's hard. I can't pick who was the funniest, but... You know, I just was really in the mood to do something fun and lighthearted and just something that I would really enjoy filming. And that was exactly what this process ended up being.
There's a lot of big names in this cast. Is there anybody who you would want to work with in future projects?
Oh, yeah. Any one of them. Except for the doll. She was a real bitch.
How was it working with a doll?
Oh, I didn't work with her.
You didn't?
She wouldn't come out of her trailer when I was around.
One year ago, in this house, one man screamed like a...
What are you doing?
Bitch, there's a ghost in the house.
Deuces!
I don't know about this place, baby.
You said that about every house we looked at.
This one's different. I just...
No, this one is perfect.
Come on, Charlotte, dude. It's like he's scared to come in the house.
Call 911. Tell him the dog is white. Tell him the dog is white.
Oh. It's happening again, Doug. I need your help.
Hell no.
In the...
You
wouldn't know anybody with an auto body shop, would you?
Are you serious, bro? Contrary to popular belief, all Mexicans don't have body shops, man. Well, you think we all have low riders with a freaking Mexican horn? Take it easy, Malcolm!
Where you going?
Go to the swap meet. We're gonna get some chihuahuas.